With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
The question is, give the products of the following reactions basically. So let us consider the first compound. So basically this is the reaction. So what our NBS do? NBS is our N-bromosuccinamide. So basically it performs bromination at the allylic carbon. Bromination at allylic carbon. Okay, so our product can be like this. Here we are having two allylic positions, this and this. So either one of the allylic position is brominated or both of them can be brominated. So the product can be like this. If one of the allylic position is brominated, CH2Br, CH3, and if both the allylic positions are brominated, like this, CH2Br, CH2Br. Okay, so these are the compounds B plus C. So let us say this is our B, this is our C. Let us consider the second reaction. So this is second reaction. In this case, since heat is given, so our reaction will proceed via free radical mechanism. Free radical mechanism. Now, what happens here is our bromine will form two bromine free radical, and this compound basically, which is this CH3 CN and double bond N CN CH3 CH3, it will undergo homolytic bond fission like this, and hence the formation of two free radicals like this will take place. Let me draw these radical as this C CN CH3 CH3, plus N2 is released. Okay, now what happened basically is our this radical CN CH3 CH3, this radical combines with bromine free radical to form such kind of compound CN CH3 Br CH3. Okay, and this compound is optically inactive because it is not having any chiral carbon. So this is our compound D here. Okay, let us consider the third reaction, which is, so in this reaction basically we are treating our compound hexene with NBS in presence of H nu. So what happened is our formation of free radical will take place like this. Okay, the formation of free radical take place like this. Now there are two possibilities for this compound. Either this free radical undergo resonance or this free radical doesn't undergo resonance. So suppose this free radical undergo resonance, then our product will be like this. This will be the free radical here, and hence it will combine with the bromine to form compound like this. And if our compound do not undergo resonance, then the product will be formed like this. Here is the bromine. Okay, our first compound, this compound show cis trans isomers, cis plus trans. Okay, and this compound do not show any isomer. So here we are having three compounds. Okay, so let us name these compounds as E, F, G. So suppose our cis conformer of the first compound is E, the trans is F, and the third one is G. Okay, now our compound is treated with NPS in the presence of DMSO. This compound is treated with NPS in the presence of DMSO and light. So what happens here is our electrophilic addition reaction will take place. Okay, our electrophilic addition reaction take place where our electrophile is Br plus and our nucleophile here will be OH minus. So it will be following Markovnikov rule, and hence the product of this reaction will be like this. Here we are having OH and here we are having Br. Okay, this is the compound number H. Now let us consider the reaction number 4, which is, so in this reaction basically we are given such kind of reagents. Okay, so what do these reagents do basically? They provide chlorine free radical. Okay, and this chlorine free radical will attack over this compound. So basically the formation of stable free radical will take place. So the stable free radical will be a 3 degree free radical, which is like this, CH3 pH. This is a stable free radical, 3 degree free radical, and hence our chlorine free radical will attack over this, and hence the formation of this compound will take place. This compound is basically optically active, so we are having the two isotopes for this compound. Okay, this compound is optically active. So this completes the answer of the question. I hope that I made myself clear. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.